Hello, my name is Lady Just. Some people are using the Fix the Country campaign to push for the return of the NDC. So let's see what the NDC did when they were in power. This is Truth in Politics. And before I go on, please like this video, subscribe to our channel and share the videos. There has been a barrage of criticism of the current administration in spite of the monumental successes it has recorded. Such criticisms can invariably lead to a change in government, and should that happen, no other political party currently exists to take the mantle except the National Democratic Congress, the NDC. So it's only fair that we look at their record in government, especially in the area of value for money, and compare apples to apples to see if the short memory that Mahama said Ghanaians have would cause them to forget the thievery that occurred under the NDC government and bring them back to power. It is simple. Example, when Kofi and Kweku take money from you to purchase the same thing, such as a house of the same specifications at the same location, but Kofi spends about 3 to 10 times the amount of money that Kweku spent, Kofi is obviously stealing from you. There's no other explanation. With this in mind, let's look are 3 projects that show how much the NDC charged Ghanaians versus how much the MPP charged Ghanaians. Then you decide which government gives Ghanaians value for money when in power and which party steals from Ghanaians when in power. Have you heard about the Ghana Interbank Retail Payment Switch System, the mobile money interoperability platform? John Mahama's NDC signed a contract of $1.2 billion with Roland Agambere's SIPTON to build one for Ghana. You do know Roland Agambere, right? Nanado, just as he went to court to get back our bauxite that Mahama gave to his brother, abrogated the contract and replaced it with a similar contract that cost you and me only $4.5 million. Okay, I don't think you heard me. Mahama and his NDC signed one contract with a company belonging to Roland Agambere for $1.2 billion with a B to build the interbank retail payment switch system. If this sounds confusing to you, look at it this way. For the same thing that the MPP bought for, let's say, 45 Ghana cedis, the NDC under Mahama wanted to charge Ghanaians for 12,000 Ghana cedis, to break it down. So for MPP taking that contract back, it saved Ghanaians 1,195,500,000. Do you know what that amount of money can do? Here are some examples. 71 of the 111 hospitals that Nanado wants to build, 8,988 ambulances, 6 years of free SHS, 231 Ghana cedis of free money to every single person living in Ghana now. And all that would have gone into the pockets of Mahama and his friends. Listen to what the Deputy Minister of Finance, Honorable John Kuma, had to say about the attempted robbery by the NDC.
So his office engaged the Bank of Ghana, and through legal advice and proper legal strategy, Ghana terminated that project, and we were able to contract local IT systems or local people to be able to offer the same services to cost Ghana only $4.5 million, from $1.2 billion reduced to $4.5 million. So from billions to $4.5 million, million. And today, Ghana is enjoying that services without a hitch. And that is the quality of leadership that the leadership of President Akufo-Addo and the MPP government offers to Ghana. So when we say that we'll protect the public purse, Ghanaians always, they say, the president, you said you protect the public purse. This is one key example of a government protecting the purse of the country.
Yeah, that was an attempted robbery. But the next one was an actual robbery that took place under the NDC administration. And for that, I want you to listen to this conversation with an admitted NDC supporter.
It's obvious. I'm a voterian. It's obvious. I'm a voterian. It's in my gene. No, I don't really know how much it cost the government, because I know that project was started by the previous government and this government completed. And I congratulate them for that. I don't know. I don't really know. Pukwasi is very bigger. The $70 million would definitely be the Pukwasi, because that is the biggest one. Seriously? So this is part of the Create Luton share. So probably the bidding was very high and they can get their shares. Dubai one was built with metal. Metal costs a lot. And the other one is cement, and we have Gazem over here.
You were part of the building.
Oh, seriously, I saw it. I even was so much impressed. I was even thinking Nkrumah started that job, because the old pillars were underground over there. I ride a lot. I've been riding for about...
You told you the number, you were surprised.
I was definitely surprised, because I wasn't...
Now you're justifying it, saying that...
It feels more like supporting.
Oh, no.
If
you can even observe my conversation, I'm not even mentioning any particular party. Yeah, it's obvious. I'm a voterian. It's obvious. I'm a voterian. It's in my gene.
The NDC is waiting and eager to return and steal Ghanaians blind. But they first have to lie to you that, pandemic or no pandemic, Ghana should be doing better. But remember that Ghana today is doing better economically, even during a pandemic, than when the NDC was in power. Finally, have you heard of the Saglimi Housing Project? Mm-hmm. That is another vehicle with which the NDC under Mahama performed a daylight robbery on Ghanaians. Listen to an NDC stalwart, Mr. E.T. Mensah.
Yes. 200 million was approved by Parliament.
Yeah.
How much were you going to spend on road and sewage and all?
No, the details are there. I can let you have it later.
Because but is there?
They did all that. Sewage, where you go there, all the asphalt that you see over there.
It's all part of the 200 million.
$200 million.
So if somebody tells us today that the 200 million excluded sewage and road and a site for the land, a service plot, we should not believe that person.
That person doesn't know what he's talking about. And they should have a copy as well out there.
And in those handing over notes, we will see that the 200 million included all of the other ancillary things.
Yes, certainly. There was no way we wouldn't have stated all this. And not only the housing, all that we did out there, everything.
The NDC administration signed a contract to build 5,000 affordable houses for a total amount of $200 million. When the MPP came in, the whole amount of $200 million had been paid to their friends, but only 1,200 houses were built, not even half of them. Simple mathematics tells us that the remaining 3,800 affordable houses are valued at $152 million and they all simply vanished under the Mahama administration. Just like the Kaswa interchange, not even half the work was done, but the whole amount of the $170 million was gone. The thievery that occurred under the NDC administration. It's mind-blowing. It's insane. These three projects alone were used to steal an estimated $1.5 billion. This amount of money can do so much for Ghana. You may have your issues with the current administration. That is understandable. And indeed, every incumbent administration faces the same criticism. But like they say, be careful what you wish for. You may get it. Ghana, like any other country, is experiencing the pandemic economy. Every country is facing monumental difficulties. But if we allow our anger to fester, we may make the mistake of bringing back the NDC. And if you thought the robbery and robbery attempts shown in this video is unacceptable, well then voting the NDC back to power would be our way of granting them the green light that robbery of the national coffers is acceptable. The NDC has done it before and they will do it again. With the Mahama administration, that will not need to face the voters again and will be worse than a dead goat. If you didn't subscribe to this channel earlier when I asked, please do so now so that you will be the first to know when our videos come out. My name is Lady Just, and this has been Truth in Politics.